Okay, so this is a 2001 Camry, but it's the same thing for a 1997 to 2001 Camry. It's the four-cylinder model. And we have an engine light. It's a P0420 engine light, which usually means like catalytic converter or oxygen sensor. Now, in this case, it's an airflow sensor, and it's located over here on the catalytic converter. There's two catalytic converters in here, I guess, but the sensor's right here, and then there's a clip over here where you basically remove it. What you do is first you remove the clip. Basically, you just press. It's just on there with pressure. And you take it off like that. Now, as you can see, it's got a combination of 1, 2, and basically 3 connectors on there. If you can see that. And what I did is I went to Rock Auto and bought the airflow sensor for my model car, and it's model 2349010, if you can see that. If not, let's see, 2349010, and it's an air fuel sensor. And basically, I went to, it's a Densco, and that's original parts for this car. I went to the Densco site, and they have a sheet or a picture of what the connector should look like for this car. And that's how I know to buy this part, because there's multiple parts for this car. And I looked at the connector, and I matched it with mine, and that's how I figured it out. So basically, you get this connector, with the sensor with the connector. I went to Harbor Freight and bought an oxygen sensor socket. It's a 3/8, and here it is. It's got a slot in it. I went to AutoZone and picked up their free loaner kit for the oxygen sensors, because the one I had didn't reach. So I got this one with the, I put the extension with my pipe wrench. You have to take the heat shield off to get to it, even with that. So you take these two bolts off on this heat shield, and I used the box wrench for that because I didn't have a socket. So now that's all off. Okay, you can start taking it. So now you can see I got my oxygen sensor here, and it's all loose. I'll take it right out. There you go. That's the old one. It's all kind of like fried and stuff, but you never know. You never know if it's good or not. There's the connector on the end like we showed you before. I have my Densco one here. It's in the plastic bag that comes in it. And they also include with it some grease. So don't bother buying any grease. You get this little grease. Densco gives you this little copper grease packet here. And then you have your oxygen sensor here. So basically, bring it up. So you got your cable and all that. Move back. Okay. So let's put the grease on here. Basically, I guess you just twist this off. And you put it on the threads. Might have to cut it. Hold on. Okay, here we go. Now I'm going to just try to get this on there without getting it all over the place. It's a lot harder not knowing that I needed a different wrench for that. Wrench I got was pretty big. It was bigger than the one I sold, but it didn't work. So basically, I guess I'll just move it around my finger a little bit. Make sure it's got good contact on all the leading threads. There you go. And then just twist it back in there again. Hand tighten at first, of course, with your hand. You don't want to mess up these threads. All right, it's in there good. Got all this copper all over me. Anyway, I got my tool back again, as you can see. And I put the tool on the wire and get it ready to go again. I'm not going to over-tighten it. I'm not going to use my bar on it. I'm just going to do it by hand. I don't want to kill it. All right, there you go. So that sensor's on there good now. Now on this heat shield, back up. Here's the heat shield again. The top screw is kind of just like a mount, so you're going to probably have to keep it on there when you first do it. So you thread it through the hole like that and get it ready to go back on. And put the bottom screw in if you can get it in. Seems to be going okay. These weren't on very tight, these bolts. I got them off with the wrench without any additional torque required. I'm not real happy with this top one. I don't know what is keeping that on there, actually. It appears maybe the bottom one's the only one that holds. Well, let me take it off again. Because when I took that top one off, the clip fell down. And I just assumed that it was just there for support. There is something there. Let me try to get... Oh, you know what? It almost looks like it snapped, which is great, right? Yeah, it looks like it snapped. It snapped right off. It's supposed to be mounted right there. And it snapped. So, more fun. Why it snapped, I don't know. I can't weld it. We'll try to still use it. Okay, cut off the recording. I got the heat shield back on. It's not really connecting to the top, but it's using it as a support. The bottom is on tight, but there's not much I can do about that unless I have somebody weld that on here, I guess. And I'm not about to get that done. What I might be able to do is put a piece of metal here to here with a screw, a metal screw, and that way it'll hold it on there. I'm not too worried about it right now. Although the engine does vibrate a lot, I'm afraid of that a little bit. But I might be able to make a bracket here to hold it on, since this one isn't really attached. But let's continue anyway. So here's the wire, and it's going to go back into the connector over here. Hopefully it fits. It should fit. If it don't, another freaking problem. Give me grief, of course. Okay, clicked. Very good. And what I'll do is I'll get another wrap here and I'll fix this. This one's dead. So I'll get another tie down and check it out. All right, you can't call it. Okay, I've been driving the car for a couple hours for about a day. So far the light's gone out. You know, I had the light because I had a P420 sensor engine alert that basically said the upstream sensor on bank one is having problems, so I replaced my air fuel ratio sensor there. And when we were doing it, the the clamp that held the top end of this heat shield on broke, and I was going to use JD Weld, but it just won't work at those temperatures, I think, so I'm not even going to bother with that. Instead, I found a bracket, and I put four rivets in it, and I bent it a little bit so that it has a little bit of pressure against the catalytic converter on the bottom, and it's on there solid, so that issue has now been solved. Let's see how long this sensor lasts, or if it fixed the problem altogether.